Tourism is such an important part of Belize's economy. We need to ensure that those systems and the systems that tourists come to see are actually intact. For example, the manatee, you know, a large charismatic mammal that people love to be able to experience, to see. Well, they are endangered, and it's the very tourism itself that's endangering them. It's the boats that are going past. Oftentimes there are boat strikes. One of the things that we're hoping to achieve is to make sure that we can find the right pathways. We can determine where the areas that boats can go to avoid these manatee strikes. That will help to maintain that population and ensure there's less collisions with manatees.
Where you find manatees, you will find abundance of species. We're gonna look at where manatees are and those are the areas that you wanna protect, because protecting manatees means protecting mangrove, protecting seagrass, protecting fishes, protecting reef.
But it's also rehabilitation, because inevitably there will be times when manatees do come in contact with boats.
The manatee rehabilitation program receives any orphaned or injured manatee from anywhere in the country. Our job is to raise them, to get them fit and well, both physically and mentally, with the life skills for life in the wild, and then to then release them back into the wild. And that's a slow process. And it entails the basic feeding, the cleaning out of the pool, but it also involves social support. A manatee calf would be with its mother 24 hours a day, so they can't be left in the pool on their own in between feeds. They actually have to have company. And if you don't have another calf, manatee calf of the right sort of age to put with it, then you have to put people in the water. We've developed a process which gives us a very high success rate in manatee rehabilitation. For an endangered species like manatees, where the national population is thought to be about 700 animals, each individual is really critical.
Any effort that we can put in place to safeguard these habitats, safeguard the things that makes Belize Belize, makes Belize pristine, would be tremendous and would be beneficial to every single Belizean, not just now, but into the future.